freezing temperatures in the central western region of Brazil have resulted in the mass deaths of livestock. In Mato Grosso do Sul, low temperatures have killed more than 1,000 bulls, cows, and calves. Local officials not ruling more animals dying out of hypothermia in the coming days due to low temperatures. Authorities estimate losses of more than $600,000. The United Nations has adopted a first-ever international treaty to govern the high seas and protect remote ecosystems that are vital to humanity. Now, this comes after more than 15 years of discussions. The High Seas Treaty will establish a legal framework to extend environment protection policies to international waters, which cover more than 60% of the Earth's surface. UN Chief Antonio Guterres urged all countries to spare no effort to ensure that the treaty is signed and ratified as soon as possible. Progress in relations between Washington and Beijing following talks between U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Chinese President Xi Jinping. The meeting comes amid increased tensions over Taiwan and Beijing's ties to the Kremlin. More in this report.
It was the highest level meeting in Beijing between U.S. and Chinese leaders in years.
Very candid, very in depth, and in places constructive. And in other places, we have a lot more work to do.
While both sides agreed on the need to stabilize communication, Secretary of State Antony Blinken will not return to Washington with an agreement from the Chinese side to set up military-to-military communication channels.
At this moment, China has not agreed to move forward with that.
Washington says military communication lines should remain open in the event of a crisis. Earlier this month, a Chinese warship came within 140 meters of a U.S. military destroyer, forcing it to slow down to avoid a crash. A week prior, over the South China Sea, a Chinese fighter jet flew across the nose of a U.S. surveillance plane. Tensions between the two nations are also high over Taiwan. China has said it wants to control the Democratic Island by military force if necessary.
The likelihood is that that would produce an economic crisis that could affect quite literally the entire world.
50% of commercial container traffic goes through the Taiwan Strait, and 70% of semiconductors are manufactured on Taiwan. On Chinese-Russian relations, Blinken said Chinese leaders have repeatedly assured the U.S. that China will not supply Russia with lethal aid that could be used in Moscow's unprovoked war against Ukraine.
What we do have ongoing concerns about, though, are Chinese firms, companies that may be providing technology that Russia can use to advance its aggression in Ukraine. And we have asked the Chinese government to be very vigilant about that.
Analysts warn that Beijing is using the move to gauge global reaction.
Clearly kind of testing the waters to see what they might do with respect to helping Russia and Ukraine. I think, as far as I can tell, the Chinese motive is they want to maintain access to the European markets while helping Putin as much as possible and creating IOUs, if you will.
U.S.-Chinese relations hit new lows since the U.S. shot down a Chinese spy balloon earlier this year that flew through U.S. airspace. Blinken's trip was originally set for February, but was rescheduled after the balloon incident. World leaders seemed pleased with the Blinken-Xi talks, with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz hailing the meeting as a sign of a much-needed normalization of relations between Washington and Beijing. Carla Babb, VOA News, Washington.
A Philippine senator files a resolution seeking to bring China's aggressive actions in the West Philippine Sea before the United Nations General Assembly. Senator Rizontiveros called on the Philippine government through the Foreign Affairs Department to sponsor a resolution before the UN Assembly. The resolution would campaign for international support in urging China to stop its harassment of Filipino fisherfolk in the West Philippine Sea. Ontiveros called Beijing's continued harassment a constant rejection of international law. At least one student is dead and another injured after a school shooting in the southern Brazilian city of Cambé. The perpetrator was a former student who entered the premises by saying he wanted to access his school records. He's currently under police custody. Brazil's president, Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, condemned the shooting in a social media post, noting Brazilians should no longer tolerate hatred and violence inside their schools and in society. The Paraná state government has declared 3 days of mourning.